Hello and welcome. On behalf of School of Education, Indira Gandhi National Open University, New Delhi. Dear candidates, in this short video, I am trying to resolve a lot of queries and confusions which many candidates often ask us through mail or through telephone calls. The candidates who want to do B.Ed from IGNOU. The very first question which may come to your mind is, that is IGNOU's B.Ed program recognized and valid? I want to tell you that yes, IGNOU's B.Ed program is a 2-year distance mode teacher training program which is duly recognized by National Council for Teacher Education, NCTE, which is the apex body, apex regulatory body for teacher education program in the country, and our B.Ed program is recognized since 2000. Our B.Ed program has its nationwide validity and it is equivalent to any other secondary teacher training program being offered by any university of the country. Even University Grants Commission, UGC, also has issued clarifications in this regard time to time. The second question is, what is the eligibility or who can do B.Ed from IGNOU? If you go through our website or if you read the B.Ed eligibility in our advertisement, you will find that it has been written there that at least 50% marks either in bachelor or in master's degree in science, social science, commerce or humanities. Means if you have done BA, BSc, BCom or MA, MSc, MCom, such degrees, minimum 50% marks are required. If you have done any bachelor in engineering or technology or any other technical course, then if you have studied science and mathematics as a subject there and you have minimum 55% marks there, this is first eligibility to take admission in B.Ed. The second eligibility is that you should be a trained in-service teacher in elementary education or you have completed a NCTE recognized teacher education program through face-to-face mode. Both these eligibilities are essential eligibilities to take admission in B.Ed program of IGNOU. Sometimes candidates ask us that can a B.Tech or other professional degree holder do B.Ed from IGNOU? Yes, any candidate who fulfills both the eligibility conditions, that is one academic 55% in case of B.Tech and the professional means a NCTE recognized teacher education program. If you have both the eligibility conditions, you can do B.Ed from IGNOU. Even candidates with B.Tech requires completion of a NCTE recognized teacher education program through face-to-face mode. The next question is, why there are two eligibility conditions? Actually, as per NCTE norm 2014, B.Ed ODL is allowed to those candidates only who have completed at least one NCTE recognized teacher education program through face-to-face mode along with graduation or post-graduation. Graduation or post-graduation, you can see, is a kind of academic eligibility, whereas completion of NCTE recognized teacher education program through face-to-face mode is a professional eligibility. So one academic and one professional eligibility, both are compulsory. When we ask to the candidates, they sometimes ask me, what do we mean by NCTE recognized program? Dear candidates, all the teacher education programs in India are valid if these are recognized by National Council for Teacher Education, which is the apex regulatory body for teacher education in India. You may find list of such programs on NCTE website. The link has been given in the slide. The next question, sometimes candidates ask to us that can a learner with DPE or DLED through open and distance learning or through any diploma in online mode can do B.Ed from IGNOU or not? No. If a teacher training program has been completed through open and distance learning mode, even from IGNOU or any other open distance university of the country or through online mode, as per NCTE norms 2014, such learners are not eligible for admission to B.Ed program of IGNOU or any other open and distance learning institute in the country. Then sometimes candidates ask us that how they can ensure that the program which they have done is NCT recognized or not. Actually, NCT issued a recognition order for each course to the teacher training institute. So if you have done any teacher training program in face-to-face mode, means the regular mode, please verify from your institute whether that program or that course is recognized by NCT or not. You can ask a copy of the NCT recognition order, or you can download it from the NCT website. Dear candidates, please remember, NCT never issue a blanket recognition to any institution. NCT always issue recognition course specific, means recognition for B.Ed, recognition for DL.Ed, recognition for DPE, recognition for M.Ed. For each course, a separate recognition is issued even to the same institution. In the eligibility, when learners or the candidates see that the in-service elementary teacher or trained teacher, what is the meaning of these terms? According to frequently asked questions given on NCT website, an in-service teacher means who is employed as a teacher in elementary school or elementary stage of education. And trained teacher means a person who has completed a NCTE recognized teacher education program through face-to-face mode. The question may come to your mind that is in-service a compulsory condition? If you see the admission eligibility for B.Ed ODL, according to the eligibility under category 2 part B, in-service is not a compulsory condition. That is, the candidates who have completed an NCT recognized teacher education program through face-to-face mode, and even they are not in job, they are eligible to do B.Ed if they are having minimum percentage in their graduation or post-graduation. When does IGNOU announce its admission? IGNOU generally offers its B.Ed program from January cycle every year. We offer programs in two cycles, January and July, but the B.Ed program we offer generally in only January cycle and not in July cycle. So we announce through national newspapers and on its website about the date of the entrance test form submission and date of the entrance test. Generally, our entrance test takes place in the month of August or September every year. When you fill the form, you may come across a question that you can apply through concerned or nearby regional center only. What do we mean by that? Actually, we function through our regional centers, and a candidate can apply under any one regional center only. So if you are a teacher and you are working at a place in a school, that the regional center under whose jurisdiction the place of your working, means the place of your school, is lying, is your concerned or nearby regional center. If you are not an in-service teacher, if you are not working, then concerned or nearby regional center means the regional center under whose jurisdiction the place of your residence lies. Does IGNOU follow central government rules or state government rules for reservation and relaxation? Being a central university, the reservation, relaxation and recognition norms as per central government are being followed by IGNOU for admission in our all programs. The next question is employment certificate mandatory? It is not mandatory if a candidate is not applying as in-service teacher. However, for in-service teacher, employment certificate from the recognized school will be considered. When does a candidate require certificate for internship from a school? Actually, in our B.Ed program, there is an internship component and which you need to complete at any government recognized upper primary, secondary or senior secondary school. So it is not required at the time of entrance test form submission. But if you qualify our entrance, then when you go for the admission counseling to our regional center will ask you to submit a certificate signed by the principal of a government recognized upper primary, secondary or senior secondary school, who gives permission to you to complete your internship of 20 weeks, that is 4 weeks in first year and 16 weeks in second year, in his or her school. The next question is, what is the minimum duration of experience for an in-service teacher? There is no specified minimum duration for service in NCTE norms. So teaching experience is not a criteria for admission to B.Ed program of IGNOU. An in-service teacher who is working presently in any recognized school after the completion of an NCTE recognized face-to-face teacher education program can apply to our program without any minimum duration of service. What is the fee structure of IGNOU? This is also a very important question. At present, the fee of B.Ed program at IGNOU is ₹55,000 for the whole program, means both the years. We take this fee in one go at the time of admission. You need not to pay anything to the study center. However, our fee is periodically reviewed and we announce before the admission to the program that what is the fee for this year. Now, who conducts entrance test for IGNOU? Sometimes candidates ask which agency does conduct entrance test for IGNOU. Earlier, we were conducting our own entrance test, but from January 2020 session, the entrance test for IGNOU's B.Ed program is being conducted by National Testing Agency once in a year. So IGNOU announces the dates along with the NTA well in advance that when our entrance test will be conducted. One question often candidates ask, what is a compulsory internship? In IGNOU's B.Ed program, a 20-week internship is a compulsory component which a learner has to complete at a government recognized upper primary, means from class 6 to 8, or secondary or senior secondary school as a full-time teacher. This internship is distributed in both the years, 4 weeks in first year and 16 weeks in second year. Then many armed forces personnel call us and they ask, is there any special provision for armed forces in eligibility conditions? NCTE has clarified in its FAQ available on NCTE website that the eligibility to admission in B.Ed program of IGNOU is same for all. There is no relaxation in eligibility for armed force personnel. One very important question is that if a candidate has completed the graduation and diploma together, is he or she eligible? If a candidate has completed his or her teacher training program and graduation and post-graduation simultaneously, then in such cases, be at IGNOU follow the UGC or Distance Education Bureau DEB norms. Whatever latest norms are available, we follow those norms. You are also requested to go through the UGC and DEB norms for simultaneous completion of 2 degrees. From where one can get the authentic information? For any information about IGNOU's B.Ed program, you are advised to visit our official website www.ignou.ac.in. You can follow our official Facebook page for the latest updates. In case of any confusion, you please feel free to contact to the director or the program coordinator of B.Ed at School of Education, IGNOU. I hope that this discussion or this clarification of different questions will help you to find out whether you are eligible for IGNOU B.Ed or not. Thank you. Thank you very much.